Okay, good afternoon everyone, and welcome to Compensation and Benefits Management online classes. Okay, so this is Dr. Mahesh M. Wanjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. Okay, so before I continue with chapter number 2, okay, strategy, the totality of decisions. Okay, let me briefly discuss one of the news articles related to compensation from Times of India, dated September 9, 2020, on page 11, that is the Times Business column. EPFO, okay, Employee Provident Fund Organization. So I repeat, Employee Provident Fund Organization. So first, let me briefly tell you what is a Provident Fund. So employees working in government or private sector, so contribute, okay, some amount from their salary towards the provident fund. Okay, though they can withdraw it, okay, in between, but generally people aim at for the long-term savings for their retirement. So the amount can be withdrawn after their retirement. In between also they can withdraw. Okay, so I'll read a news related to that also. Okay, so and equal amount is also contributed by the employer. Okay, and if you can recall the webinar by Ramesh Dayalan, Associate Vice President of ADP India, okay, he mentioned 12% of the basic salary, okay, is contributed towards the provident fund of the employee. It is a statutory requirement. Okay, so there is a news article related to this, and also in our chapter number 1, components of salary or forms of pay. In that slide, there was a figure mentioning total returns, okay, to the employee that were broadly classified into cash compensation and okay, so psychological returns. So in cash compensation there were two, okay, the second one was benefits. Among them the first one was income protection, okay, through various forms of in health insurance policies, provident fund, gratuity. Okay, so at the time of the retirement the employee will have some amount in his hand to take care of himself or herself. So provident fund is one of the monetary benefits which come under, okay, benefits section in the total returns. Okay, so this is how you can relate the theory to the practical or corporate world. So the news title is EPFO settles 94.4 lakh claims worth 35,445 crore rupees in 5 months. So as I mentioned, okay, though generally it is aimed at a long-term savings for post-retirement, but in between also there are provisions employees can withdraw for their requirement. So this news is about that. Retirement fund body EPFO has settled 94.41 lakh claims totaling 35,445 crore rupees during April, August, despite COVID-19 related restrictions, an official statement said on Tuesday. During this period, the Employees Provident Fund Organization, which is EPFO, has settled around 32% of more claims as compared to the corresponding year of last year, April, August, 2019, while the amount disbursed increased by 13%. Okay, so how it happened, how they did it. To help its members, means once an employee is registered with EPFO and starts making contribution towards his or her provident fund, okay, one becomes member of EPFO. So I'm talking about all those salaried class who are contributing towards their provident fund, these members. To help its members tide over the liquidity needs during this crisis, that's COVID-19 crisis in last 5 months, EPFO fast-tracked settling of COVID-19 advances and illness-related claims. So there are two types of withdrawals that happened. One is COVID-19 related advances. Okay, so you can withdraw some amount in advance like a overdraft facility in bank, and illness-related claims. So those who incurred expenditure for hospital and claimed the to remember for that claim, okay, they have withdrawn money from provident fund. It introduced auto mode of settlement for these two categories of advances. Only for these two types of withdrawals, okay, the EPFO has designed auto mode of settlement. Auto mode of settlement reduced the claim settlement cycle to just 3 days for most claims in these two categories against the statutory requirement to settle claims within 20 days. So generally, it would require about 20 days when you withdraw the amount. Okay, but under this auto mode, only within 3 days, okay, the withdrawals have been successfully made. And there is some information also. Notably, 55% of advance claims settled during April-August 2020 were related to the recently introduced COVID-19 advance. So COVID-19 advance is a recently introduced facility. So 55% of the advance claims were in this category. And 31% advances settled during the period pertain to illness claims and remaining are others. Wage-wise analysis highlights that almost 75% of COVID-19 advances and roughly 79% of illness-related claims were settled for Provident Fund subscribers belonging to wage slabs less than Rs. 15,000 per month. Okay, so the major beneficiaries or the majority of the people who have withdrawn from their Provident Fund account are those people whose monthly income was less than 15,000 rupees. So it was need-based. Okay, so I hope you can understand. Okay. So if you have any queries related to this, you can ask at the end of the session. Okay, so with this brief news, I'm going to continue from chapter 2, okay, where we left. So Sharon, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So my voice is clear?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
You could see the news article, right?
Yes, sir. That article we can see, sir.
Okay. Now I will share PowerPoint slides. Just orally answer me. Huh? Once you can see it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, Sharon, can you see the PowerPoint slide?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay. So before I continue, let me take a quick recap of what we learned in previous class. So we have started learning the compensation strategy, okay, which is the result of the totality of the decisions taken with respect to the building blocks of a pay model, which includes objectives and the four policy choices that are internal alignment, external competitiveness, employee contribution, and management. Okay, so we learned about, okay, the strategy, what does strategy mean, and the strategy at different levels in a corporation, like corporate level, business unit level, and functional level. I considered the example of Tata Group of companies, Tata Motors, and HR department in Tata Motors. Okay. Then we understood that the compensation strategy should support business strategy. So you design compensation in such a way where it motivates the employees to work towards the organizational goals. Okay. Then we discussed how the compensation system can be tailored to the business strategy, means how you can make the employees motivate or influence to work towards achieving the organizational objective or goals. Okay. Yeah. Then we learned that compensation strategy is nothing but the decisions made with respect to these building blocks of a pay model. That is the objective, internal alignment, external competitiveness, employee contributions, and management of the pay system. So that is what it says. Decisions based on the five strategic compensation choices of the pay model, which I read in the previous slide, taken together form a pattern that becomes an organization's compensation strategy. Okay. So definitely at the end of the chapter, I will give you a clear example of how a compensation strategy looks like. for two companies. One is Microsoft, okay, and another is SAS, okay. Two software companies. So then let me continue from here to understand how this company, Whole Foods Market Incorporation, has designed a compensation strategy in a way to support its business strategy. Okay, so I repeat, I'm going to give an illustration of a Whole Foods Market Incorporation regarding how this company has aligned its compensation system, okay, to support its business strategy. So a brief information about this company. It is an American company. Whole Foods Market Incorporation is an American multinational supermarket chain headquartered in Austin, Texas, which exclusively sells products free from hydrogenated fats and artificial colors, flavors, and preservatives. So this is a competitive advantage or differentiating strategy or positioning of Whole Foods. Okay. If you want more information, you can browse the website of this company for additional information. But this much information is sufficient for the time being. So the strategic compensation decisions facing Whole Foods. So the first building block in the pay model is objectives. So regarding objectives, how should compensation support business strategy and be adaptive to cultural and regulatory global environment? So this is the question in front of Whole Foods Market Incorporation. So Whole Foods objectives. So let us learn about the Whole Foods Market Incorporation. Is a retail chain. It is a company. Okay. If somebody of you has switched off your mind, the next 7 slides we are going to learn about compensation strategy of Whole Foods, and we understand how it supports their business strategy. With this background, which I repeated, now let me go ahead with the illustration. So what are the Whole Foods objectives? So we are going to discuss the building blocks of objectives and 4 policy choices with respect to Whole Foods. So Whole Foods objectives include increase shareholder value through profits and growth. Second, go to extraordinary lengths to satisfy and delight customers. See, because it is a chain of retail stores, brick and mortar retail stores. Okay, so company can grow and make more profits only when the customers make repeat visit. Means when the customers become loyal to the nearby stores. Okay, so by that way, the sales profits are going to continue for the company. The company is going to grow, and that is how the shareholder value can be increased. Seek and engage employees who are going to help the company make money. So I explained how the company can make money. There should be employees in the store who can provide the service, quality of service, which can delight the customers and convert them into loyal customers. So these loyal customers, when continue to make repeated purchase from the store, okay, the company makes sales and its sales grow, as well as it increases the shareholders' value. So one of the objectives of this company is to recruit and select such kind of employees who have the potential to delight the customers. And this way, they are going to help the company make money. So definitely, again, compensation is the most important aspect here in achieving this objective. So let us see how compensation will be aligned for this. Then second is internal alignment. How differently should that various types and the levels of skills and work be paid within the organization? Say I'll consider a micro level, say one store. Even if I consider store manager, department manager, and customer service associates. Customer service associates are the one who, okay, stand in respective departments and greet the customer. And if customer needs any help, they actually provide the help to the customer. Okay, so a manager and a customer service associate, both will require a different skill set. Okay, so definitely, how differently should the various types and levels of skills and work be paid within organization? This is the question for Whole Foods. and Whole Foods approach. Store operations are organized around 8 to 10 self-managed teams. So in each store, the total number of employees are divided into teams of up to 8 to 10 people. So that is the first way how the employees are internally aligned. Egalitarian shared fate philosophy. Okay, egalitarian philosophy means equality. All are equal. Please remember, it is a political philosophy which is also considered in business organization with respect to employees. So I repeat, egalitarian means all are equal. Equality approach. So egalitarian shared fate philosophy prevails in Whole Foods company. Executive salaries means vice president, for example, managing director, vice president, CEO, CFO, COO, are executives. So executive salaries do not exceed 14 times the average pay of all the full-time employees. So all the full-time employees, whatever is paid, an average is taken, and it is managed that the executive salaries do not exceed 14 times the average pay of full-time employees. So please try to understand, when we say 14 times, it is far lower compared to other organizations where the executive salaries may exceed beyond 30 times or 40 times, sometimes 50 times the average pay of full-time employees. So all full-time employees qualify for stock options. See, pay attention. In many companies, all full-time employees do not qualify for stock option. Stock option means these employees are given an opportunity to purchase equity shares of the company. Okay. So when the company makes profits, they receive dividend, or they can even sell the stock and make money. So all full-time employees qualify for stock options. So this is the egalitarian approach, equality, all are equal. And 94% of the company's options go to non-executive employees. So the percentage of the equity shares that are kept for ESOP, that is as employee stock option, out of that, 94% of the stock options go to non-executive employees. Okay, so this is how Whole Foods treats its employees equally. Okay, so this is how Whole Foods has aligned its employees internally. Then, external competitiveness. How should total compensation be positioned against our competitors? So this is a question for Whole Foods. It has competitors as well. What forms of compensation should we use? So two questions are there here. So how Whole Foods should differentiate itself against its competitors in terms of pay? And second thing is, what forms of compensation should they use? Like more of cash compensation, benefits, or psychological, relational benefits. So what is the approach of Whole Foods in this case? Whole Foods offer a unique deal compared to competitors. Okay, definitely very unique deal. That is, they provide health insurance for all full-time employees, as well as 20 hours of paid time a year to do volunteer work. Okay, so when I say 20 hours of paid time a year, in 1 year, some employees volunteer for some social work. Okay, so such work is encouraged by this company. Okay, up to a maximum of 20 hours. Okay, let us say in 1 week, 2 hours, for example, or in 1 month, 5 hours, for example, that way. It depends on the company policies. These employees can go and engage in volunteer work. So up to 20 hours of that, volunteer social service work is paid. Means employees' wages are not deducted for 20 hours. It means their salary is made per hour. Okay, hourly basis they are paid. And the company also provides health insurance for all full-time employees. Okay. And I'll just take you to the homepage website of this company to give you more details about how their offer or compensation is unique compared to competitors and what kind of benefits they provide to their employees. Okay. Sharon, can you see this page?
Yes, sir. Google, I can see, sir.
Yeah, it will open 1 minute. Okay, so this is the website of company Whole Foods Market Incorporation. You can see it, right, Sharon?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in this section, search jobs. You don't search. Huh? It is not, this company is not in India. So whole benefits to employees. See, look at the options. Physical health. It's a fact you are a happier, more productive person when your body feels 100%. We give you access to everything you need to stay in tip-top shape. Believe me, okay? It is not a dialogue like in Indian companies or movies. The company does follow this. Otherwise, the example wouldn't have been in the best-selling book on the subject. Okay, pay attention. Comprehensive health insurance. Yeah, I read it out. Company provides health insurance to all its full-time employees. So we provide our full-time team members with access to health insurance to keep you feeling great. Then dental vision. Okay. Keep your teeth healthy and your eyes sharp. Okay. With a comprehensive vision and dental coverage. Okay. So if your teeth are good, you can smile, give a good smile to customers. Then spotlight. Total health immersion programs. Okay. Then mental health is also taken care. Then career learning and development. Whole Planet Foundation team member volunteer program. I spoke 20 hours of the volunteer work is paid by the organization for each employee. For 2 to 3 weeks every year, team members can apply to travel to the communities where Whole Foods Market sources products and funds microcredit clients through its Whole Planet Foundation. Okay. Team member assistance. Okay. Then supporting volunteerism. Okay. So one of the employees, Shivan W. Okay. She speaks about Whole Foods Market supports what I do in my free time. I'm an extremely active volunteer in the Austin area and the company encourages me to take time to volunteer. Okay. See, I hope I'm bringing the picture alive. It's not just theory points that are being read or explained. Okay. It's a live demonstration of what I'm teaching in the class. Financial health is also taken care. We have a history of rewarding great work. These are reason we were one of the first grocers to set minimum pay for a higher than our competitors. So this company pays higher salary than its competitors. So competitive pay, they say about your talent and drive to make the world a better place is valuable. So we make sure our pay reflects that. Savings for future, discounts that matter, PTO cash, okay? So these all are the benefits, or you can consider it as a compensation strategy of Whole Foods Market Incorporation, which helps or which supports its business strategy. So definitely can imagine with all such facilities and work environment, the employees will be highly motivated to delight the customer through which the store or company makes money and increases shareholder value, okay? I'll go back to my previous slide, previous share. Okay, Sharon, can you see this slide now?
Sharon? Yes, sir.
Okay. So that previous website of a company also is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. So see, this is what I have always told you. If you read some information from company websites or news sites or newspaper, magazine, okay, so it is not difficult. Okay, so you will find that what is written in the book is extracted or learned from the practices of the organizations only. Okay, so no fool can say that what you read in the book doesn't exist in reality or in corporate. Okay, so please read from credible sources and try to understand and analyze. It's not about by-hearting. So I'll move to the next building block. Employee contributions. Should pay increases be based on individual and or team performance, on experience and or continuous learning, on improved skills, on changes in cost of living, on personal needs, and or on each business unit's performance? So these are the questions or options in front of the company. So let us say this company, Whole Foods Market Incorporation, what it has adopted with respect to employee contributions. A shared fate. Every 4 weeks, assess the performance of each team. So please recall how the company has made its internal alignment. Okay. So store operations are organized around 8 to 10 self-managed teams. Okay. So a shared fate, every 4 weeks, assess the performance of that team, which comprises of 8 to 10 members in store. Then top teams get an extra $1.5 to $2 an hour. So I already explained, in this company, the store employees are paid based on hourly basis. Okay, so top teams. Okay, so within the store, those teams that perform, okay, better. So the employees or members in that team are entitled to get an extra $1.5 or $2 an hour in addition to what they get generally. Okay. So usually this extra amount is credited in the next month's salary or pay. Then management, how open and transparent should pay decisions be to all employees? To what extent the pay decision should be made transparent or known to employees? Who should be involved in designing and managing the system? So what is the Whole Foods approach with respect to management of pay system? No secrets management means pay decisions are made very transparent. Every store has a book listing. Every store has a book listing the previous year's pay for every employee, including executives. So any employee in any store can actually see how much is paid for the employees, not only in his store, but also for the executives of the company. So the company has maintained transparency. It's possible because remember, they have adopted the egalitarian approach, means all are equal. So you decide. Employees recently voted to pick their health insurance rather than having one imposed by leadership. So there are so many options from the company website I read out. Okay, so among them, like mental health, dental health, okay, health insurance, you can recall. Employees are given an option to choose whatever they feel is, okay, good for them or suits them. It's not a company dumps on them the types of plans or policies. Okay, so this is with respect to management. Okay, so this is what we learned about compensation strategy. So what is it? It is the totality of the decisions taken by a company with respect to object compensation objectives and the four building blocks of compensation, that are internal alignment, external competitiveness, employee contribution, and management. Okay, so it will not stop at this level. Two more illustrations are also there, okay, to take you to the depths of compensation strategy. Okay, so yeah, I think I will pause here to take your questions. Okay, so now there is an option, you can unmute from your end. So those who have questions, unmute yourself, ask the question and mute yourself again. So time for question answers or clarifying your doubts. Yes, students.
Sir, can you explain employee contribution once more?
Employee contribution. Why? Voice was not audible clearly.
Yes, sir, it was audible. I did not understand.
You have to ask. It's not about explaining one more time. What is your doubt? What you did not understood?
Like now a shared fate every 4 weeks. So how is it? I did not get it, sir.
See, shared fate means, okay, this is English. Okay, you need to understand. Shared fate means we already learned in the internal alignment that in the company, in each store, the employees are divided into a teams of 8 to 10 members. Do you remember?
Yes, sir.
Let us say all those 8 to 10 members are working in one department, fruit section, let us say. Okay?
Okay.
Then that section, fruit sections, how much the fruit section contributed to the total sales of the store? That is found out. It is possible. Okay. Then if the contribution of the fruit section is greater than any other section in the store, it means that the employees in that team who are working in the fruit section have performed better than others in the store. Okay. So all 8 to 10 members will get an extra pay of $1.5 to $2 per hour. That is what we say shared fate. And let us say one more section, vegetable section. Okay. The contribution from the vegetable section to the total store sales are lowest. It means they have underperformed. So that team is not entitled to get extra pay of $1.5 or $2 per hour. So since they did not do well, everybody loses this extra earnings. So fruit section, since they performed exceptionally well, everybody is entitled to get this extra pay. That is what is called as shared fate.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Clear?
Yeah, yes, well. Sir.
Yeah, good. Next question. Yeah, next question. Okay, dear students, please make proper utilization of the available time. I'm giving you enough time to clarify your doubts. Okay. Yes, any queries? Still we have about 2.5 minutes time.